So we know that the sentence is in present tense. All the options are in present tense. So that's not a criteria here. We need to see which one is the best. So are being considered. Whenever you see being on the GMAT, you have to be extra critical. You need to see whether the usage is justified. A being is not needed. You know, so the even if we remove the word being, for example, what we have in option E, duo is considered. So the sentence would be all right. So B and E can be eliminated. You don't say R for duo. Duo is a collective noun. It is singular. So options which use an R can be eliminated. This is anyway eliminated now. Now it's between C and E. And now a bit of modifier after winning something something. See, this is entire a modifying phrase, and whatever comes after the comma would be modifying this phrase. So we need to ensure that what comes after the comma is something that after winning all the four Grand Slam blah blah can refer to it. Okay, so this can refer to Bob Bryan, Mike Bryan duo. It cannot refer to America. It's sounding as if America has won the four Grand Slam tennis. That is not the intended meaning. Therefore, option C can also be eliminated. E is the best choice.